fresh fire.
Something that I've been meditating upon and that's been so heavy upon my heart for so long is the supernatural. And I'm asking myself the question, what is stopping me and you as young people to perform the supernatural? Because there must be more than we've been seeing and heard and experienced up until now. And what is stopping us? There was a day I was sitting at a gate of a school and I saw this young boy. He was about a grade 10 or 12, and he was running around on his crutches because his one leg was amputated. And I saw him playing soccer, kicking with the one leg, hitting with the crutch, and it really broke my heart because I'm thinking, Lord, it was never your purpose for him to end up like that. And it was like a voice telling me, but I can restore back to him what's been stolen. And it hit me like, yes, we must press in for the supernatural. That is what God wants us to do. John 14 verse 12 and 13 says, I assure you, most solemnly I tell you, if anyone steadfastly believe in me, he will himself be able to do these things that I do, and he will do even greater things than these, because I go to the Father, and I myself will grant whatever you ask in my name, as presenting all that I am, so the Father may be glorified and extolled through the Son. We need to believe in Christ. Christ, the Anointed One and His anointing. He is alive within me and you. We were created in His image. We are the manifested sons of God. So He has enabled and equipped us to do these supernatural things. John 14, verse 16 and 17. I will ask the Father and He will give you another comforter, helper, intercessor, advocate, strengthener, and standby, that He may remain with you forever. He will never leave us nor forsake us. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, welcome, take to its heart, because it does not know or see Him or recognize Him. But you know and recognize Him, for He lives with you and constantly will be in you. We need to be filled with the Holy Spirit. He is our guide and our helper. And we need to listen to His voice. We need to learn to hear His voice, because He will lead us. He will guide us. And even though sometimes it will sound silly, but we just need to obey what He says and tells us to do. Matthew 12, verse 2, 4, and 5. Now when John in prison heard about the activities of Christ, he sent a message by his disciples and asked him, are you the one who was to come, or should we keep on expecting a different one? And Jesus replied to them, go and report to John what you hear and see. The blind receive their sight, the lame walk, the lepers are cleansed by healing, and the deaf hear, the dead are raised, and the poor have the good news, the gospel preached to them. Jesus gave us the authority to go and do the supernatural, preach the gospel, and do greater things than He has done. It is time that the world will see the supernatural be manifested, because that is what they hunger for. The blind see, the deaf hear, the dead being raised, the cripples walk, and limbs growing back, oil, gold, silver being manifested, angels, and far beyond what we can think or imagine or pray for. So don't hesitate. Just take that first step of faith. All God wants is a willing heart. So don't allow any accusation or condemnation to stop you from what Christ has for you in the supernatural. He paid the price on the cross. You are free. So nothing can stop you. Christ has made you able. The supernatural is for you. So why wait?